My previous video on Interstellar Comet 3IL got a lot of interest and tons of really good questions. A couple of exciting new observations published in the past few days mean it's time for another update. There have been several observations of the comet, including with the Hall 42-inch telescope at the Lowell Observatory, but in this video, I'm going to focus on those by SPHEREx and JWST. The spectrophotometer for the history of the universe, epoch of reionization, and ICE's explorer, or SPHEREx, made 72 observations of 3I Atlas of 115 seconds each between August the 8th and the 12th. These observations were combined with data from NASA's infrared telescope facility on Mauna Kea, taken on August 11th. The SPHEREx team found significant carbon dioxide gas emission from the nucleus of the comet, along with evidence for significant water ice in the nucleus. This is very typical for short-period comets in the solar system and is solid evidence for 3I Atlas being a comet. One common comment on my previous video was that 3I Atlas wasn't a comet because it didn't look like a comet. Part of that is down to the fact that the tail of the comet is currently very weak and hard to see, although it was observed by the Hubble Space Telescope. Along with the tail, the other part of a comet that people think of is the coma. That's the hazy bubble of dust and ice around the nucleus of the comet that we sometimes see. Typically, the coma gets stronger as a comet gets closer to the sun and it's warmed up, causing more sublimation of the icy nucleus. SPHEREx did not find any evidence for a dust coma, but that's not surprising, as we'll see. SPHEREx pixels are around 6 arc seconds, but we know from the Hubble Space Telescope observations that the coma is likely around 3 arc seconds by 5 arc seconds, meaning SPHEREx wouldn't have the ability to resolve it. A big shout out to Brendan Krill and Olivia Dore, who are on the SPHEREx science team and who I work with on the Planck mission during my time at JPL. This is such a cool result, and it'll be interesting to see what SPHEREx finds when it observes 3I Atlas again in November and December of this year. Let's get into the JWST near-cam observations of 3I Atlas from August the 6th. The observations are at similar wavelengths to the ones from SPHEREx, but JWST has way better resolution at 0.07 arc seconds. That's not a criticism of SPHEREx. The two telescopes are just designed to do very different jobs. As you can see in this image, though, the resolution makes a big difference visually. For SPHEREx, the comet is just a point source, but for JWST, we can see a nucleus and a clear coma around it. Spectroscopy with JWST that you can see on screen confirms the SPHEREx results, showing a carbon dioxide-dominated coma that's outgassing more towards the sun, which makes sense as that's the hotter side of the comet. JWST also detected the presence of water, carbon monoxide, carbonyl sulfide, water ice, and dust. The team did report a very high carbon dioxide to water mixing ratio, among the highest ever seen. This mixing ratio essentially expresses how much carbon dioxide the comet is outgassing compared to how much water. The mixing ratio can also vary over time and location in the solar system, but the ratio for 3I Atlas is high compared to other comets, although not completely crazy. One possible explanation for this is that the comet formed in a carbon dioxide-rich part of its own solar system. That's the update. Of course, the biggest question on the last video was whether this is an alien spacecraft. All I can say is that the observations are all consistent with a comet and that there is nothing to suggest that this is anything other than an interesting comet from another solar system. Nobody would love to discover alien life more than astronomers, but scientists follow the data, not the hype, and that's a great rule to keep in mind. That's the video. I hope you learned something. Please drop a like and subscribe if you did, and I will catch you in the next one.